हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू पार्ट टू इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ सेट इंटरवल विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेट टाइम आउट। इफ यू गाइस हैव डायरेक्टली लैंडेड टू पार्ट टू एंड यू आर नॉट फैमिलियर विद सेट टाइम आउट और सेट इंटरवल, फील फ्री टू वॉच पार्ट वन फर्स्ट। द लिंक टू पार्ट वन इज अवेलेबल इन डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी मोर टाइम, लेट्स जंप टू इम्प्लीमेंटेशन। हियर यू कैन सी दैट वी आर यूजिंग द सेम एग्जाम्पल दैट वी हैव यूज्ड इन सेट इंटरवल एक्सप्लेनेशन। We are passing the greeting function to set interval with a delay of 1 second. This means that the greeting function will be called after every 1 second. Now, if we will look into greeting definition, so you can see that we are incrementing the counter by 1. Then we are having a console statement that will print hello Puneet, and at the end we are checking if the counter is greater than or equal to 3, then we are clearing the interval. This means that this greeting function should be called 3 times after every 1 second. Now let's run this small code snippet. Here you can see that hello Puneet is printed 3 times after every 1 second. Now we want to achieve this functionality with our own polyfill. So I will first replace the names set interval with set interval polyfill and clear interval with clear interval polyfill. Now we want to define these two functions. So I'll create these two functions. I'll get these two functions from a single function call like this. Clear interval polyfill. So let's name the new function as create set interval polyfill. So the reason why we are creating this from a new function is the set interval will return as an ID that is used by clear interval to clear that interval. So there must be a mapping between these two, and we do not want to pollute the global scope. That is why we are creating it into our new create set interval polyfill function. So now we will define this function. So I will write the placeholder for create set interval polyfill, and there are no arguments passed, so the argument list is empty. Now at the end it should return these two functions, set interval polyfill and clear interval polyfill. So I'll write a return statement from here. Now we have to define set interval polyfill and clear interval polyfill in this. Now let's first create placeholder for both these functions. Also for clear interval polyfill. As we know that set interval polyfill will take a callback function, then delay, and by default delay is 0, and rest all the arguments are passed to the callback function at the time of its execution. And the clear interval polyfill will take interval ID as the arguments. So now every time this set interval is called, we have to create a unique ID and return that ID from here. So to create that unique ID, we will be needing few variables in the closure scope. So I'll create a interval ID and I will initialize it with 0. I will also create a interval map and by default it is an empty object. So both of these are in the closure scope. If you guys are not aware about the closure scope, we have created another video on closure. I will mention the link in the description section, you can watch it later. For now you can just think that both of these variables can be accessed by set interval polyfill and clear interval polyfill even after the scope of this create set interval polyfill is over. So what these two variables signifies, the first one is interval ID, so it will help us in creating unique ID for the set interval polyfill. And this interval map will contain the mapping of the ID that we are creating in set interval polyfill and the ID that is returned by the real set timeout. So if we'll talk about set interval polyfill, every time it is called, we have to create a new ID from the previous ID. I'll increment every time, and at the end I will return this ID from here. So this ID should be unique every time. Now, whenever this function is called, what we have to do, we have to repeat some logic. So I'll create a new function. Let's name it as repeat. So inside this repeat function, I will update my interval map. So add the ID that we have created with the set timeout call. So the set timeout should be passed a function and a delay that is received from the arguments. So in this function call, I will call the callback function with the arguments that are received, and I'll check. So there must be a terminating condition here. For us, this will be the interval map at the ID. If we have a value in the ID for the interval map, then we will call the repeat function again. So why we are having this condition? Because at the time of clear interval, we will delete this ID from our map. So I guess this is it. So first of all, we should type check that the function is either a function or not. So I'll have a type check of this callback function. It should be a function if this is not a function, then we should throw a new type error, and we can message here. So we can just say callback should be a function. So if this is not a function, we'll throw an error, else we'll create a unique ID, then we have a repeat function every time this function is called. So we will update our set interval at this ID, and we'll call the callback function with the arguments, and we will check if the interval map at the ID has a value, then we will repeat the function. So one thing that we have missed to call this repeat function for the first time. So I guess this is it for set interval polyfill. Now let's define clear interval polyfill. So its definition is very simple. First of all, we will clear the timeout. So the clear timeout on this map with the ID that we have received. So I'll use this map and I'll pass this ID to it. Also, I want to delete this from my map. So next I will delete. So this is about the threat interval polyfill. Now let's test this with few examples. Now I will run the code again, so you can see here, hello Puneet is printed 3 times after every 1 second. Now if I'll change this greeting function to a blank string and I will run it again, you can see that it throws an error, callback should be a function. Now let's say I want to pass it with few arguments, so and just replace it again with the greeting function, and I want to print Yumesh in place of Puneet. So I'll pass Yumesh from here, and in place of Puneet, I will receive name in the arguments, and I will print name. Now if I will run it again, you can see that hello Yumesh is printed for 3 times after every 1 second. One important point to remember here is that this polyfill is just for interview purpose and not the full-fledged implementation that you should use in your production level code. So that is all about set interval polyfill. If you guys have liked the video, please hit the like button. Do subscribe to our channel if you want to watch more videos like this. Do comment if you have any feedback or suggestions. Thank you for watching.